One day I was parking with my car on a hill and I saw a hang glider man gliding with his machine, and I saw that this one bar just moved a little bit. And then I thought, my God, so simple. It's just one tube, but a big one. Well, why not taking everything away from the bottom of the wheelchair and just make one bar with a corner down here, one bend, that's it. So I right away next day, I prototyped, and so the competition got born. The competition was light years ahead of everything else. First of all, it was a minimum frame design, which means nothing was on the bottom. It's not only less parts, but it's much more easy to transport. For example, you could pull the chair to took the wheels away because it was a rigid chair and sit it like a person sit it on the side chair because there was no frame structure with lifted, for example. That was the practicability aspect for everyday use. Secondly, it was so simple designed that the front caster and the back axle were slidable, adjustable stepless. So I could have every angle, every height in front or back, whatever I want. I could just open two screws, bzzz, the whole chair. So for basketball, to the rules, you go high as possible. For slalom, for the rules in sport, you want to sit as low as possible to have a maneuverability. The chair had everything, everything. And the most impressive moment which I got rewarded about this design was when I visited a dealer in Norway, in Oslo, and I saw an elder, white-haired lady, 63, 64 years old. She was sitting in a competition chair. The basketball Olympic medal with the American team, half of it, had this chair. Then I went to her and said, "Excuse me, why have you chosen this chair? Don't I sit comfortable?" I said, "Yeah, it looks like I feel comfortable." So that was the genius thing, having something for seniors, for kids, and the highest competitive chair in the basketball world. And the chair was the example for the future. So every company in the world got now this design. And the chair was priced of independent architects and engineers for being accepted for the permanent exhibition in the Museum of Modern Art in New York. So that was the first healthcare item ever which one got voted. But they saw that is a design. What can you achieve more?